Thank you, Colonel Khare, for giving us the overview of the industry. Let us quickly move on now to the first session of the symposium, What Ails the Indian Broadcasting Sector? Broadcasters and regulator TRAI are at odds over the new tariff order, which was introduced in February 2019. Experts believe there is a disconnect between stakeholders and regulators and understanding Indian consumers. As a result, there is constant tweaking of the regulatory regime, causing unease of doing business, uncertainty in bringing fresh investment and ensuring return of investment. The question in stakeholders' mind is that with over three decades of existence, why is the Indian broadcasting industry yet to reach its full potential? So we will be discussing that. I would like to quickly invite the moderator and the panelists one by one as I introduce you. And I will be making the introductions very brief for lack of time. The moderator is Mr. Shaji Matthews, who is an industry observer and a consultant. Mr. Matthews is Mumbai-based, and till September 2019, he was the CEO of Kerala Communicators Cable Limited. And prior to this, he was working as the Chief Operating Officer of GTPL Hathway Limited, a multi-service operator engaged in cable television distribution, reaching an estimated 8 million households in over 169 cities across 10 states in India. Before that, he was Executive Vice President and Head of Digital Cable at IMCL, Hinduja Group, and Senior Vice President at Starden Media Services. Mr. Matthews, thank you very much for agreeing to moderate this session. You're welcome. May I now invite our panelists one by one? The first panelist is Mr. Prashant Chothani, founder and CMD of Travel XP, which is the world's leading travel channel and founded in 2008. In 2011, February, Travel XP launched India's first and only HD travel channel with 100% original programming in English. The channel is located in over 15 languages and distributed to 97 million homes plus over North America, Europe, MENA, and the Asia Pacific. Mr. Chothani has developed a strong, talented team that he mentors with strategic leadership for technology infrastructure, foreign alliances, and partnerships. Also content creation, distribution technology. He's also the CEO of Media Worldwide Limited, which broadcasts India's leading music channels, Music India, Sangeet Bangla, Sangeet Marathi, Sangeet Bhojpuri, and Bangla Talkies. Mr. Chothani, thank you very much for agreeing to be a part of this session. Our next panelist is Mr. Shirish Patanshetty, MD of Entertain Media, Fakht Marathi. Mr. Patanshetty has spent a decade in the world of media and advertising. He started his journey with DRTV Media in 2002 and made it a success. His entrepreneurial motto is, if you fail fast, you should recover faster. He successfully launched the Imagine movie channel in the UAE market and kept it running for many years. He is today the co-promoter of Fakht Marathi, a Marathi GEC channel, which is part of the Entertain Television Private Limited Group. His sharp acumen and wit attending to detailing has contributed to the success of this channel. Mr. Patanshetty, thank you very much for agreeing to be a part of this panel. Our next panelist is Mr. Suresh Sethia, Director, ICNCL Kolkata. If there is no plan, Surishda creates one. Where others fear the challenges of disruption, Mr. Suresh seizes the opportunities. He has cut through the noise of this transformative age by breaking away from the pack, and he has ended up leading it. He is the, like I said, the director of the Indian Cable Net Company Limited, and it has state-of-the-art, non-parallel cable TV head end, which is the best in Asia and caters to 6 million plus cable TV set-top boxes across the entire East and Northeast region of India with all value-added services. He has constantly pioneered several firsts in the industry, launched the play-top boxes with YouTube facility on a non-smart TV and Android set-top boxes much before competition could even think of it. He's an exemplary visionary and corporate strategist, and he's a director on boards of several companies for his strong leadership, qualities, and rich experience. Mr. Sethia, thank you very much for being a part of this panel. And Mr. Subhashish Majumdar, who is a top management professional and digital media expert. He has a career spanning over 32 years in corporate multi-industry experience at managerial levels in several businesses and management functions. He is a postgraduate from IIM Ahmedabad. He has over 16 years of intense and high-profile experience in the TV media industry, especially for digitization of the TV services sector by fiber and satellite technology, including broadband industry. Presently, he's Director General Operations at Lovely Professional University, and he has also helped various media distribution, digital customer care, etc. Thank you very much for being a part of this panel. I hand over the session now to the moderator. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Rastogi Saab, for giving us this opportunity. The topic that we are discussing here is what ails the Indian broadcasting industry. Broadcasting industry ko kaun sa bimari hai? Agar koi bimari nahi hai, to we can say that there is no bimari. We are very well, we are healthy and moving ahead. But humne ye suna raston ke sab bol rahe the ki hum hatash hai. So hatash hona hai to kuch ta kuch some ailment has to be there. So over three decades, industry has been existing and a lot of changes have been happening in this industry. Why so many changes are happening? What is driving these changes? What further needs to be changed? These are the things that we would deliberate. Now some of the points that have come to our mind, we will bring before you. I will start with Mr. Prashant Chotani. He operates more than 14 channels. He's a global player, 9 channels in India and you know, almost 14 channels globally. So in India, one of the points which came to my mind was that the content broadcasting sector is generally dictated to and by 4 major groups. Who sort of monopolize the entire content and everything is driven by them, pricing or norms or even regulatory interventions are influenced by a lot of them. So do you think this has been good for the industry or bad for the industry, and this overweight with the few players, will the new coming of OTT and content through other mediums and more popularity for regional channels, will that be the solution to this? Your views.
Good afternoon. Thank you, Rastogi ji, bulane ke liye. Old wine, new bottle. Ye ab tak sahi tha. अब न्यू बॉटल नो वाइन, हम वहां पे हैं. कुछ ग्रुप्स के पास कंटेंट आप कह रहे हैं कि कॉन्सेंट्रेट हो गया है, इसके लिए जिम्मेदार हम हैं, केबल इंडस्ट्री है जिन्होंने उनको ज्यादा स्पेस दी. आप इंडिपेंडेंट ब्रॉडकास्ट बिजनेसेस को आपने वायबिलिटी ऑप्शन नहीं दिया सर्वाइव करने के लिए, इसलिए वो थ्राइव नहीं कर पाए. ग्लोबली जैसे मैं बिजनेस करता हूँ तो मैं देखता हूँ वहाँ पर, चाहे डॉयचे टेलीकॉम हो या कॉमकास्ट हो, दे आर आइदर मैंडेटेड बाय लॉ और सेल्फ रेगुलेटेड. 20% ऑफ देयर प्रोग्रामिंग बजट इज गिवन टू इंडिपेंडेंट स्टूडियोज, नॉट द बिग फोर्स. वहाँ भी कार्टलाइजेशन था. Netflix was a result of cartelization, के content देंगे नहीं, तो ये तो हो गया, अब उसको कुछ कर नहीं सकते. अब केबल इंडस्ट्री के पास सबसे बड़ी समस्या है, और अपॉर्चुनिटी तो बहुत सालों से है. मैं भी 1987 में मुंबई में केबल ऑपरेटरी था, तो इसी बिरादरी का हूँ. 1988 में केबल टीवी, खरे साहब को जरा करेक्ट कर दूँ, के फर्स्ट जजमेंट 1988 पे सुजाता मनोहर का आया था कॉपीराइट का, वो मेरे खिलाफ ही फाइट हुआ था फिल्म इंडस्ट्री का, जहाँ पर केबल बाय कोर्ट लीगलाइज हुआ था कि केबल टीवी इज़ नॉट इलीगल, वी जस्ट नीड द कॉपीराइट. और 88 के बाद 94 में एक्ट बना, लेकिन 88 में चूंकि कोर्ट ने माना ये इलीगल नहीं है, फिल्म इंडस्ट्री कोर्ट में गई थी और कहा था ये इलीगल है, तो वो वहाँ पे ये चेंज हुआ था। हमारे पास स्ट्रेंथ क्या है एज ए केबल कंपनी? हमारी केबल्स जो बिछी हुई हैं, खरे साहब ने जैसे कहा कि हम ब्रॉडबैंड के लिए अलग तार डाल रहे हैं, यानी हम दूसरे के स्टेडियम पे गेम खेल रहे हैं। हमारे स्टेडियम पे आओ ना खेलने के लिए, हमारी कोएक्सियल केबल लगी हुई है, हमारा इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर जो केबल ऑपरेटर का लगा हुआ है हम उसको आज तक कैपिटलाइज कर ही नहीं पाए। कॉन्फ्लिक्ट ऑफ कैरेज एंड कॉन्टेंट, कॉन्फ्लिक्ट ऑफ कैरेज एंड कंज्यूमर, केबल ऑपरेटर या MSO को ये तय करना पड़ेगा कि मेरा कंज्यूमर कौन है। इन द OTT बिजनेस देर इज नो कैरेज, इन द OTT बिजनेस कॉन्टेंट इज पेड फॉर, नथिंग इज फ्री। कंज्यूमर भी पे करता है और डिलीवरी करने वाला भी पे करता है। मैं CDN कॉस्ट देता हूँ अगर मैं डिजिटली डिलीवर करता हूँ, कंज्यूमर भी पे करता है अगर वो कॉन्टेंट देखता है, और कोई इंटरमीडिएटरी नहीं है। इंटरमीडिएटरी ISP है, जो टेलको है वो कमाता है दोनों साइड से, चाहे मैं कंटेंट भेज रहा हूँ या कंज्यूमर कंटेंट देख रहा है। और केबल इंडस्ट्री टेलको नहीं बन सकती, खत्म, वो दिन खत्म हो गया। अगर यूनिवर्सल लाइसेंस बहुत पहले ले चुके होते, MVNO आता तो सिटी केबल के नाम पे हम मोबाइल फ़ोन लेते हैं, जैसे बाकी डेवलप और इवन सेंट्रल ईस्टर्न यूरोपियन कंट्रीज़ में केबल कंपनीज खुद टेलकोज हैं वहाँ पर, तो वहाँ आप अपना खुद का मोबाइल नेटवर्क एज ए वर्चुअल मोबाइल नेटवर्क ऑपरेटर आप खड़ा कर सकते हो। आपको होलसेल रेट प्रोटेक्शन है, वो अभी तक यहाँ पे लॉज है नहीं, वहाँ पे होलसेल और रिटेल रेट्स में फ़र्क है। तो आपके पास जो केबल बिछी हुई है आप उसका पूरा पोटेंशियल यूज़ कीजिए। NCF कहता है 200 चैनल, आप 600 डाल दीजिए। कोई OTT प्लेयर में दम नहीं है 600 लीनियर चैनल स्ट्रीम करके हर कंज्यूमर की टेस्ट को सेटिस्फाई करेगा, क्योंकि कॉस्ट है देखने वाले को भी। जैसे खरे साहब ने कहा, फ्री टू एयर देखने की भी कॉस्ट है फॉर द कंज्यूमर। ये अगर केबल इंडस्ट्री यहाँ नहीं जागेगी तब तक प्रॉब्लम है। आप टेलको का इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर यूज़ कीजिए फॉर द OTT बिजनेस। एंड सबसे बड़ा खतरा जो है, आपने पता नहीं अगर लोगों ने पढ़ा कि नहीं पढ़ा, कल जी इज शटिंग डाउन ऑल लीनियर चैनल्स इन ऑल इंटरनेशनल मार्केट्स इन 3 quarters। स्टार ने US में लीनियर टेलीविजन कम्प्लीटली बंद कर दिया है, सिर्फ OTT पे अवेलेबल है। तो सोचिए कल अगर स्टार या IPL केबल पे नहीं आकर सिर्फ हॉटस्टार पर आएगा, सिर्फ सोचिए क्या होगा। या जितने भी सोप्स चल रहे हैं आपके टेलीविजन पर, ये सारे के सारे स्केल डाउन हो जाएंगे प्रोडक्शन में और सारा कंटेंट सिर्फ OTT पे आएगा। हर कंटेंट प्रोवाइडर B2B2B2C के बदले में B2C करना चाहता है, ये गेम है। अगर इस गेम को आपने नहीं समझा तो आप इससे बाहर हो जाएंगे। टैरिफ ऑर्डर में एक और प्रॉब्लम है कि डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन प्लेटफॉर्म अपनी खुद की सर्विसेज नहीं चला सकता है। एक कंसल्टेशन पेपर आया था कि DTH कितने वैस सर्विस चला सकता है, केबल ऑपरेटर कितनी वैस सर्विस चला सकता है, उसको केबल फ्रेटर्निटी ने फाइट नहीं किया। केबल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन कंपनीज आर ऑल्सो कॉन्टेंट कंपनीज। आप मुझे एक केबल कंपनी बताइए पूरे हिंदुस्तान में जहाँ पे कॉन्टेंट के बारे में सोचने वाला आदमी है जिसको मैं बताऊँ कॉन्टेंट क्या है। देर इज नो बडी हु इज लुकिंग आफ्टर कॉन्टेंट इन ए वेरी होलिस्टिक मैनर। आपके पास बैंडविड्थ अनलिमिटेड है, आप मैक्सिमम HD चैनल्स दीजिए, क्योंकि स्ट्रीमिंग में HD होता ही नहीं है, स्टैंडर्ड डेफिनेशन हो जाता है क्योंकि बैंडविड्थ कम हो जाती है। आप 4K दीजिए। अगर आपको लीनियर में, अगर आपको इंटरनेट पे 4K चैनल देखना है तो 25 Mbps सस्टेंड चाहिए मिनिमम। घर में 4 लोग हैं तो 100 Mbps सस्टेंड चाहिए, कभी नहीं होगा, ये केबल पे ही हो सकता है। तो केबल वालों के पास ये है अपॉर्चुनिटी, इसको अभी एनकैश नहीं करेंगे तो ये अपॉर्चुनिटी भी खत्म हो जाएगी, क्योंकि तब तक फाइबर आ जाएगा, फिर सबके घर में गीगाबिट कनेक्शन हो जाएगा, 4-5 साल हैं, पैरिटी आ जाएगी नेटवर्क में।
या सो व्हाट यू आर सेइंग वाज दैट मेनी ऑफ दिस बिगर प्लेयर्स आर द शटिंग डाउन देयर लीनियर चैनल्स इन इंटरनेशनल मार्केट्स We should also remember that it is because of the lack of viability to run the linear channels, because the cost of running linear channels in international markets is much higher as compared to being on IP or online. Okay, let me now move to Sethia Saab. Sureshji, one of the points that we have been talking about is that industry, everyone says our industry has been disorganized, it's a disorganized area. We are, not disciplined enough. Too many issues, which are lying, so many loose ends, low ARPUs. Just now, Prashantji said about, the potential for the industry to run their own contents and develop their own contents, but we have not significantly done anything about it. So what is your view about this?
Good afternoon. Prashantji has given some jitters in our stomach. He's saying linear channels internationally band ho ja rahe hain, so that could affect our country as well. Before giving Shahji's answer, I want to give that to him. Our industry has grown because of the linear channels, and linear channels ki demand nahi hoti to every day you will not be getting new and new channels coming up. Still, there are so many channels who want to come to the forefront. The MIB is not giving them permissions. If they loosen the permissions, I think another 200 channels you'll have in India. So I don't see any such challenge in India immediately. Long run, probably both of them will survive. As far as OTT business is concerned, it is not regulated as of now. So probably when you have the regulations in place, we will see what exactly happens to that platform. Because that platform is left unregulated by the government, when they come out with the regulations, we'll definitely see a change there as well. This industry grew suddenly without any government norms, like Kare Saab was telling a few minutes back, ki abhi tak to broadcasting license aaj tak nahi bana, to jab, when you don't have the licenses or the way of practicing business in place, the business is, Shahji, normally unorganized. For every individual is taking a call as per the business needs and the requirements. The only good part was, when you don't have laws in place, business grows fast. So cable TV suddenly grew the mammothness, which it would not have gone had there been laws. So probably that was good for the industry. The last few years trying to bring down all the regulations in place. And wo thodi der pehle Rastogi saab bol rahe the ke NTO 1, NTO 2, probably every year we'll have NTOs. So 1 year has passed, one NTO, second year has started, second NTO, and I don't know how many more NTOs we'll be seeing in future. But I still believe the regulations should not be that harsh that it hampers the business. Last 1 year had been really difficult, I think, for all sectors. The broadcasting, the MSOs, the cable operator, I think it has not been good even for the consumers. NTO 2, till it is implemented, till it comes out of the court, what exactly happens, I don't want to quote on it, but it is very important for try to understand that whatever they bring, consumer benefits, it should be industry benefit as well. Agar industry ka benefit nahi hoga, I don't see consumer benefits happening. And I would surely believe that all the stakeholders will agree with me ki abhi tak NTO regimes have not helped any one of us. But some organizations have happened because of these regulations. The deselection has happened. Had government not been so strict on it, deselection would not have taken place so fast that it has taken, so it has been good. Kare Saab was talking about billing. Kare Saab, 1 million subscriber, 5 or 7 MSOs ke hain. So wo requirement thi nahi desh ki. Desh ki requirement bahut kam thi. Bahut kam requirement thi. Aaj ke din bhi 10,000, 20,000, 25,000 एक लाख वाले बहुत MSOs हैं एंड प्रॉब्ली द SMS सिस्टम दैट हैज बीन गिवन इट वाज ऑफ द ओपिनियन कि मे बी यू विल हैव 4-5 पैकेजेस दैट इज द नीड ऑफ द कंज्यूमर्स कंज्यूमर्स स्टिल डोंट डिसाइड द पैकेजेस इन इंडिया एंड सो द सब्सक्राइबर मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम वुड हैव सस्टेन बट विद अ न्यू NTO रेजिम इन प्लेस एंड द वे ट्राई वॉन्ट्स इट कि मोर एंड मोर अलाकार्ट इज टू बी सोल्ड maybe you will have to upgrade your SMS systems, maybe your cash system, maybe your set-top box softwares. If everything happens the way Tri is saying that more and more people will choose a la carte. But if again with whatever Tri says and it goes back to the system that was adopted, I think the existing SMS system will again work. India being India, I'm hopeful the consumer still depends on cable operators. The cable operators understand the mentality of their consumers. So they can come out with packages which suits their consumers and maybe limited number of packages will again work for them. I mean, total agreement with Prashantji that we should give as many channels possible. Jitne jyada denge, the competitors have to bring that much on the platform, which is difficult for any other platform except cable TV. So I think, Saji, that we have got a little organized business than what we had previous, and I'm very hopeful things will do be better.
So, Satya Sahib, so what you are saying is that our industry is like a tree which is grown big and then somebody is trying to crop it into some shape, but we should not cut too much. If you cut too much, the whole shape itself will go out of it. I do agree with you that the growth of the industry has been phenomenal and everyone here takes credit for that. Let me move to Subhashish. Subhashish has been in the industry for a very long time and has been part of the regulatory process very actively during his senior positions that he held at IMCL. Subhashish, do you agree with Satya sir that regulation should not be harsh? That is the word that he used. Now, and do you think that NTO will help the industry to reach some shape, or will it harm the whole issue? The whole idea of the regulator that people should go for a la carte. Now, it is my view that this industry didn't grow because of a la carte. This industry grew because there were large number of channels available to the consumer. It is not by going to a la carte. So, is a la carte any method which is going to help the industry, or it is going to be harmful to the industry? Also, we see that broadcasters are generally against the regulations. So, do you think that too much of regulation has been an issue with the industry, or what is your view?
Thank you, Shaji. Very good afternoon to all of you. I think this is a very loaded points which Shaji wants me to answer at this house, and I'm sure the answers will be echoed. But let me just take a step backward and let us understand what already I think Dr. Khare Sahib has already explained the entire genesis of the industry. I will not go into that. But just to quickly take from the time when this industry was growing, and obviously huge congratulations to the entire cable industry who actually made the entrepreneurship industry. Today we are talking of, I am in a place where we talk of entrepreneurships and startup, and the entire country is looking forward for that. That startup and entrepreneurship happened with this group, the cable group, possibly 25 years back, and it was obviously going in the direction of obviously market-related growth, and it was moving in the right direction. I think it only happened when the other stakeholders came into picture. And then every stakeholder, whether it was from international or national, all saw that there was a huge cream pie in this country to use it and devour it, and possibly to scuttle some of the, I would say, in a small way, non-organized platforms which were working strongly to take it in a different direction. And if you recall the time from 95 to 2002, I think both Dr. Khare and Dr. Rastogi mentioned, I remember the percentage growth of the pay content was 500% in just 5 years' time. So that was the time possibly the stakeholders themselves realized that there needs to be some kind of a method in madness. So obviously it was the stakeholders who went to government, who that time TRAI was not even there. When the TRAI came into picture in 2004-05, that was the first time when the already the CAS enactment kind of happened, and it was with some kind of a formula. That time it was a very, very rudimentary formula which was given of rupees 5, etc., all over the place, which was not liked by anybody, and the TRAI, I mean the CAS was lying in a limbo for 5, 6, 7 years. Again, it was realized that the formula given by some of the stakeholders to make their own set was, and the big four maybe, whoever came there, the entire ownership of the pie which was coming from the customer or rather the business ecosystem was being controlled by them. So again, it was becoming a very important issue for the distribution groups to ensure that you get a proper share in that system. Otherwise, it was becoming more and more difficult that how can you continue to please the pay content owners and continue to have your own growth. So possibly the stakeholders went to TRAI once or twice or thrice. And then finally, it was agreed that let us have some kind of system, although the industry had grown on our own and it was completely on our own. Now you go to the three TRAI regulations, mainly when the DAS came, which was just a DAS, and which was the formula was to have the old analog pricing, which was given, and on that some 35% or 40% was accepted. The model was purely wholesale pricing, which was also affecting the price model, but still it was independent. And it was felt that possibly the growth was going on, but it was also felt that there was a complete skewness in the models of the stakeholders itself. And again, that issue came up. Even in that point of time, if you recall, all the three stakeholders said that we are not making money and there's a problem. But actually, one of the groups was making money, which was possibly the big four content pay groups at some level, because it was a wholesale pricing and the pricing formula was derived from the analog method. That is how finally the so-called MRP method of the new NTO came into place to ensure possibly a bit more realistic view that all the stakeholders have some kind of a say. And the concept of this NCF, which was not there earlier, means for supplying a network, there is a cost. I agree that is a cost between the so-called hidden provider and the network provider together. There has to be a basic cost, you cannot deny it. And even if you do not give a single channel or if you give a single channel, that cost has to be there as your own. I think that concept was accepted by the regulator, let us agree on that, which gave some kind of a viability that yes, there is a minimum basic amount with the just the free content. So on the assumption that even if there is no pay content, you are allowed to earn a minimum amount of whatever was agreed. Now coming to NTO 1 and NTO 2, the difference, obviously NTO 2 has also gone into some other issues. Shaji just mentioned that, you know, all the NTOs and regulations are not liked by the broadcaster. If you observe it, Shaji, it is the four big four pay groups who don't like it. I'm sure that some of my friends who are sitting here from the broadcasting community, both FTA channels and the other channels, may not mind it so much because the growth of the content, I will come to that quickly, but let me finish off this one. The issue and the growth of the content in this country has been kind of completely monopolized and halted by some of the big four groups, and the small players and the individual aggregator players could not move in that direction. So, problem what happened is that these four continued to hold the full fray, and then the NTO 2 was realized that after you have got a semblance possibly in the market, which was said that yes, there is some kind of a shareholding pattern which is happening, it was a tough time for the entire industry to come with that. The NTO 2 only thing which I believe personally is that it is possibly the TRAI has taken a measure that now that possibly you guys have stabilized, let us give the benefit to the consumers and let us have the market in that regulated format, which may or may not go in the direction because there are already concerns in the court and in the market, but it may take its own time. But even if you hold it for a while, for 2 minutes, there are two more areas which I want to definitely info. I'm thankful to Mr. Prashant and Khare Saab and Dr. Sogi also. The content issue. I think we have not utilized the content of the platform like the way it should be. You take any example in anywhere in the world of the fiber domain or the cable domain. We have completely restricted or gone ourselves with only the so-called linear platforms of the big broadcasting and thought that content is not my domain at all, I don't have to bother. But as you know, by all rules and regulations, by all the policies, a cable group is allowed to do its own content and make it, and you don't have to necessarily give a satellite content. Today, after the digitalization, you have the ability to do your own vast contents, which you can do 10, 20, 50. There are some MSOs in this country, I hope you're aware, who are giving more than 80, 90 channels, which is of their own so-called vast, in whichever format. I think we have worked very, very limited way for that. The idea was that we, and today also, it is very important that we should take a take work behind and see what is happening to the Indian industry of the content consumption. The consumers are the king finally, neither the distribution nor the content in that way. The consumer dictates what behavior pattern we should move ahead. So if you leave aside whatever NTO1, NTO2 is happening, just imagine that can we have a business models which are more closer to so-called, which the industry and the consumers have adapted up to some level, whether it's the Netflixes and Amazons of the world. We have not really even thought that there can be a huge vast ability of using the content which are already there in India in a big way. Dr. Rastogi mentioned that we have so much of content, right from the ancient content of 1940s, whether it's a film, whether it's a, and today's the new areas are, the, for example, short films. You have the contents of which are aggregated internationally, whether it's a kids or Hollywood or other countries or Korean or Turkish, etc. These are not required in the broadcaster level. I can only tell you that there are in the country, there are some developing new aggregators and the content providers, and you yourself can become a content provider, nobody stops you. And then you can start making this content so alive to make a ARPU benefit in a different way. I agree that there has been an issue of so-called controlling the NCF at 200 channels for 130 and now 160 for X number of channels, but I think that is only the tip of the iceberg. Why should we bother that, okay, FTA, what Mr. Prashant also mentioned, that the FTAs are meant to ensure the stability of the network. Today you can compete with so-called OTTs and Netflixes of the world to ensure that nobody can give that number of channels as a FTA. The more important part is that have we done something for the consumer consumption pattern of the media and content to see that what all contents we can give, which is not related to the so-called big four pay groups at all, but you can still make your pay yourself. And that is the strategy which I think more and more groups can start with that. And once you start with that, you can price it at X amount as a bundle, as a a la carte, as whichever way. The issue of a la carte versus bundling, I completely agree, it is a market-driven thing. It is a consumer-driven thing. The Indian consumer is smart enough to decide whether he wants it or not. Yes, the international behavior pattern has always been that the consumer have always liked to take in a more bouquet format rather than a la carte format. So the requirement of pushing it to a la carte may or may not give a final result to the government and TRI. That's a different story, because we have to assume, and we are the businessmen, we are the marketeers, we know the market better, we know the consumer better. All of you, we have been working for 20, 25 years in this industry. We know what works for the, as Sethia Saab straight away said, it is ultimately the market is known to each and every person who has worked in this industry for last 10, 15, 20 years. And once you work out in that fashion, your requirement of so-called regulations should be kept completely aside. If you ask my personal view, that these regulations should be just seen as a marker to start something, but we have to work in a different direction. For how many years, please tell me, that we have really given a consumer behavior pattern to analyze it? We have the data of the digital data already, which we have all over the place. Have we analyzed them? Have we marketed them in a social platform or any digital format to give any kind of new services, any kind of new additions? I think we are still to do a lot of work in that. We have, Dr. Rastogi mentioned that today the cable operator is so strong that he is so well known to the family, to the full group. You can start giving more and more services, which is through the pipe itself, or which is your own content, your own VAS, your own movies. In fact, there is a requirement. We did a small research 1 year back to see that the consumers want today ad-free contents, which hardly anybody is giving. And ad-free contents of any value, which is in an international work or national work, which is given of a good quality, can give a huge benefit for that. So I think these are some of the things which we have to do. The regulations will have their own limitations, I would say, because no regulation is perfect in any way, neither in this country nor anywhere in the world, Shahji. I can assure you that. Because the regulations are given to test a market, and they are given when the industry stakeholders are possibly not getting the right way in their own format. Actually, if you ask me, the regulation was not there at all up to 2005. The industry possibly worked the best. So the regulator will continue to try that there is a semblance of the stakeholders across. But I think we should step aside of the regulator plan, whatever his plan or whatever. We should plan our own, like FMCG companies or any other creative companies now, to formalize in a new direction. Because you are having so-called challenge and competition from the big telcos who will come as a complete fiber delivery. You have OTTs. I think we have to adapt in some format and start giving the services in your own way. So one of the ways I already mentioned that you can give 80 or 100 channels of your own. Who is stopping you? You don't have to make a satellite channels of your own at all. Aaj ke din mein aap log cable mein 50 se 100 channel apne aap aggregate karke agar 25 rupaye mein bhi dete hain, I can assure you that 100% of your population will take those contents. Aap uske baad dekhenge ki aapka jo choice rahega of so-called big pay issues, jisme ki aapko lagta hai ki aapka profit kam hai jata. See, you have to increase your own profitability. At the end of it, we have also a business. At the end of it, agar apna profitability hai, to humko uske liye kaam karna hai. Humko sabke profitability ke liye jod nahi dena hai. If I am running the business, it is important ki how do I run my own business. And that is the concept which our friendly broadcasters are doing, and that is the concept which we should do more aggressively. And I can assure you, just now I am very happy to know that Dr. Rastogi mentioned that we will have a collaboration of all the so-called small headend operators, headend owners. I would say that today India is looking for two things. One is, you must have heard the word MSME. We call medium scale level players and the entrepreneurs players. You are all there. Today, even in the MSO regime, I'm sorry, Shethia Sahab, I don't mean you, but there are 5-6 players only who have taken the mantle to do it. But it is you all who are having averaging from anywhere from 1 lakh to 4 lakh or 5 lakh or 10 lakh who can really go the market in a different way. And I completely subscribe to that fact. And if there is a kind of a plan and a strategy, you can see again the same ownership and strategy and entrepreneurship which happened possibly 20 years back should come into this forum. And there are the guidance, there are the mentors who can always give it. Obviously, there are directions from people like Mr. Sethia, who was himself an entrepreneur. He started, and today he's sitting on a huge number of customers who are completely loyal to him. These are the examples which we have to make in each market. Each market is different. Please also appreciate that you have the huge capability, because your each market in cable, you have the ability to give the content whichever you want in your own way in any region, which possibly even an OTT or a DTH will have their own problems. OTT has a different plan, so I'm not comparing them also with the so-called fiber broadcasting delivery, which I agree completely. But if you compare with your satellite-based services, whether it's a HITS or whether it's a DTH, I think the pure cable group has a huge ability to do that. We have not formalized that. So the takeaways are that, yes, there will be difficult regulations at times, which happens even in Ofcom and it happens in US, etc. But it is up to us to make the market. I think we should not be too much disturbed with the kind of so-called regulation which they have given. We have to show a place in our own entrepreneurship way that what we can do, you can say indirectly by business-wise, is scuttling this regulation and making our own business sense and ensuring the customer is finally the king and I can give him whatever he wants. And I build a market for him because I know him better than anybody else, including the regulator or the government. I think that is the final takeaway and that is how we should move ahead.
Subhashish, the message that you are trying to give is that don't get disturbed by what is happening in regulation and various other things. Use your strengths. I think what he was bringing emphasis is on that to have your own content, you know, reduce your dependence on linear channels and build your own content, build your own channels. If you remember, if you go back to the history of cable, I think cable started as a video channel industry.
Absolutely.
So that was the owned cable. That was the strength of his industry. The local channel which you were running, that is the strength. That still is the strength of this industry. So it is high time that I think this. He is absolutely right. This is an area which has been left out the focus has gone out of this area for most of the cable networks because they are disturbed by all these other things which are happening. It is time that the industry went back to building their own content and strengthening the platforms. I also agree with you on the...
Saji, if you see East, you will find at least 40, 50 channels which are not satellite channels. They are just server-based channels and they have been operating in different parts of Bengal for, I can say, more than 10 years, 15 years now. And they've got a good model. As MSOs, we also have our own channels. And I see the best thing is that you have got event channels which shows events happening in the city, events happening in the district, and that you don't find in anywhere else in any linear or a satellite channel.
Yeah, and only thing is I just wanted to add up that please make a business model for that. Either you make it an ad business model or a pay business model. The benefit of the regulation also you should take. No regulator is stopping you to make any channels as pay channels. You can club your own so-called channels into 10, 20 and make a pay channel format of that also. I think today, that's exactly what I meant by scuttling the ability of the regulator. And one point I should add up before you can continue on that. The another area is of the so-called collection method and mechanism. I think that area has been debated for a while. There have been issues of prepaid versus postpaid, which is again not much related to the regulator. But I think again for that, there is enough technology and enough apps and enough things which have come into the system. I think we should again use it at our own level, at the small MSO level and the cable. Nobody stops it there. Because today you can intermingle with the so-called SMS and these apps or any kind of new format to ensure the collection mechanism much faster with a much lesser number of people and derive your entire business model based on the so-called benefits of the delivery and anything which you give, sir, I agree.
Surely. Yeah. That is an area, I think, which can go into a bigger discussion, actually.
So I don't, but at the same time, I completely agree that whatever content you are doing, please monetize and capitalize on that content in some way or the other and ensure to market it also to the consumers, because today the kind of marketing which goes for any kind of SaaS Bohu or any other serials is still much more than possibly our own content which we give it to the my own consumer even in a local area.
Yeah, absolutely. Subhashish, also you're pointing to NCF. I completely agree with you on that, and in fact, on the other hand, I agree a little more with Khare Saab, who said that instead of calling it network capacity fee, it should have been called connectivity fee, which would have been definitely more acceptable to consumer and the right way to put it across. Now, this takes me to another scenario where you would have all been seeing this video which has been going around, where the major broadcasters have been saying that why there should be any consumer pay anything for watching free-to-air channels. Why should there be an NCF at all? Now, this takes me to another scenario where this question is to Shirish. See, it is very strange that in this industry, there is no respect between the stakeholders. There is a broadcaster, there is an MSO, there is a last mile operator and consumer. Now, a lot of times it so happens that the last mile operator is nowhere taken into consideration in many of the regulations or business models, but he absolutely is the most important link to the consumer. It is also, we can see that, you know, all these stakeholders call each other by some really bad words, like everyone calls the other a cheater. You know, every stakeholder calls the other stakeholder a cheater. Now, this is not the scenario which is not there in any industry. If you take the FMCG or the consumer durable, or you take the tire industry or the electronic industry, there is a manufacturer, there is a distributor, there is a retailer. They all work together. There is absolutely nobody calls anybody else a cheater. This is a very strange thing in this industry. Now, is this something which has been... Why is this kind of a scenario there, Shirish? You have been a broadcaster with more than 6 channels and operating in a lot of regional markets, especially. Carriage fee and placement fee is something for which, you know, the broadcaster says that the cable operator is a cheat and he is taking too much money for all these things. So what is your view? Is this one of the issues which has been troubling this industry, this lack of trust and mutual respect between the players?
Thanks, Shaji. Good afternoon, everybody. While answering to Shaji's question on this, the most important part in the entire scenario is the right content. Now, when we are talking of the big four, the big fours are monetizing it in multiple ways. One is the subscription fee that all of y'all collect and give it to them, and the advertising revenue as well. What happens with the free-to-view viewer channels? Free-to-view viewer channels take a long time to survive by themselves. They take between 3 to 5 years to create an establishment. Between these 3 to 5 years, where they get worn out before giving the right type of content is in carriage fees. Don't take me wrong, I'm not saying carriage fees should not be taken or whatever, but there should be a consideration. More than carriage fees, for the NCF or for a broadcaster to give the right content, you need to give these channels the right placement. If you give these channels the right placement, I'm sure in time, they will give you your viewer experience to be better. Your viewers will definitely keep demanding. If you want to create a competition between a pay and a free viewer per se, there has to be content that has to be driven. Not everybody in this space is able to deliver high quality content. While Prashant has done an excellent thing with his travel XP, that it is being demanded by a consumer once they go and see the channels. It is his niche category. While there is a lot of competition on GEC channels because the content creators require a lot of money. So every serial is expensive because the big fours are paying big monies. Hence, I would say that if there is an option being given, the free-to-viewer channels should get the right proportion of getting placed to accommodate them.
Yeah, Shirish, so you are saying that there is nothing wrong with carriage fee. It is just that, you know, you have to also keep in mind that the channel is given the right position so that the consumer feels happy about it.
No, so only when there is a right type of pricing, the broadcaster will be able to pump money in creating the content. So content is also expensive. Content is no more cheap. I don't believe OTT is a competition to direct television. OTT is a option for an individual viewing. India by far is a family viewing habit. While there have been other signs that there are still 100 million homes which need televisions to come in, which means that there is still growth. So we are now at 198 million connectivity, and the total population connectivity is 297. So there's still 99 million homes which need to be connected with television in form of cable, DTH, whatever you call it.
Prashant,
I'll just add on to what Shirish was saying. Shirish has picked up a right point that free-to-air channels, if they have to come to a platform on the top, then they need to be placed properly. As an MSO, what problem we faced was, initially, the big four channels came, so we placed in the first four places, then another channels came. So we had been placing their channels as per when they came to the picture. We could not have placed them one above because they were already placed. Fortunately, now the carriage system is been governed by TRAI, where they have got to put the regulations in place. Fortunately, by 1st of March, you have got a time that you can replace your channels. After 1st of March, whatever channels will be placed, I think for a long period till you switch them off, will have to remain in that position only. So once they are placed, then again you will have the same problem, that my channels are not placed properly because somebody has already put that in place. Somebody must have come knowing well that by 1st of March you have to put the channels in place. They get it placed. So there is a possibility now when the existing broadcasters can replace their channels with the big four channels or any other channels they think is important.
Prashant, your views.
Given the TRAI's regulations in place.
Your views.
Suresh ji, yahan bhi deal kar rahe.
भाई आ जाइए एक तारीख से पहले बाद में नो द होल इकोसिस्टम देयर इज मिसट्रस्ट व्हाई द बेसिक फंडामेंटल इशू दिस इज द ओनली इंडस्ट्री वेयर द सप्लायर इज ऑल्सो ए कस्टमर दैट इज द बोन ऑफ कंटेंशन फॉर मिसट्रस्ट and that is the bone of contention for transparency also. So if you will see all regulations that be it TRAI or TDSAT or wherever all regulators are struggling to identify balance between carriage and pricing. If you remove the carriage part and if you treat that, okay, what is a cable operator? He is selling content to the consumer or he is providing content to the consumer. As Shirish ji said, if you don't leave money with him to create quality content, then don't complain that there are only four groups. Allow them to create. Everybody is a creator, please understand. All social media platforms have come out of people who could create great content. We are a great country with great creative minds. Platform is an issue. Now the cable industry has built a platform. It has to monetize it. It could have wanted 200, we are talking 198 million homes. Please understand, in the last three quarters, there is a tapering growth on DTH net adds. If you see, in the last three quarters, there is a big signal. Nobody is looking into it, nobody is talking. But in the last three quarters, there is a negative growth on DTH net additions. And that too on 90-day active period. Actually speaking, internally, on DTH, there is negative growth in the last three quarters. That means that cable will also have that cycle coming in. And the fall will be steep in the next 3 years if there is no wake-up call. India will largely remain a cable market or a DTH market, depending on who is able to serve them better. Believe me, we are 4 months, there is monsoon. So every house has one cable, one DTH. Anybody who removes cable and when there is monsoon, he will call the operator. Arre bhaiya, ghar pe laga ke ja. So you have to thank the rain gods. Like this country is always dependent on rain. The cable TV industry is also because of rain. We are here. Utilize the pipe, as Khareji said. You have unlimited bandwidth. Bhar do sare channel jitne bhi hain. Do sabko. And market it to the consumer, as Shubhashi said. Tell the customer, 900 channels. इंडियन कंज्यूमर साइकोलॉजी क्या है 900 चैनल मिल रहे हैं मैं देखता क्या हूं वो इंपॉर्टेंट नहीं है सो ट्राइज एजम्पशन दैट द कंज्यूमर इज गिवन 500 चैनल्स बट ही इज वॉचिंग 10 दैट इज कंप्लीटली इलॉजिकल हुज बेनिफिट द रेगुलेशन इज एक्चुअली दे आर ट्राइंग टू फाइंड ट्रांसपेरेंसी दे डोंट वॉन्ट लिटिगेशन ऑन कैरेज दे डोंट वॉन्ट लिटिगेशन ऑन सब्सक्रिप्शन एग्रीमेंट्स and they want parity between a small player and a big player. So there is equal opportunity given. I think the regulation NTO 1 or 2 or whatever is in the right direction. Only thing, we are not used to be disciplined. Humne signal laga diya to hum rukenge hi nahi. UK mein raat ko 1 baje signal band hai, raaste pe koi nahi hai, banda ruk jata hai. Usko malum hi nahi hai, signal tod sakte hai. Hamare wahan to pata hi nahi hai, signal pe rukna hai, seedha todna hai. Problem ye hai. So regulations are good. It will ultimately help the market grow. The industry has to reinvent itself. Aur kuch karna nahi hai. Aapko ek paise ka investment nahi hai. Inke 6 channel hai, mere 6 hai, dusro ke 6 honge, iske 6 honge. Ye beauty hai ye business ki aapke paas. Free to air channel available hai. Dal do andar seedha. Kyun pakan bari kar rahe ho? Nahi nahi, wo carriage nahi de raha, main nahi dalunga. Are kyun bhai, dal do sabko, zara ghusa do. Customer se paisa lo. अगर आप देखेंगे तो कैरेज धीरे धीरे नीचे ही जाएगी और अभी कैरेज का रेगुलेशन है वो भी डाइसी है वो होने वाला नहीं है सुरेश जी 3-4 अटेंड लगा देंगे बोलेंगे पर अटेंड है ना ठीक है अभी ये असनसोल में नहीं आ रहा है या हल्दिया में नहीं चल रहा है ऐसा चालू हो जाएगा टिप दिया आपको
I don't think you should take Prashant's remark that you know this country is country of rains so don't worry at all You know, because DTH आने के पहले भी यहाँ बारिश था फिर भी DTH आ गया सो आई डोंट थिंक यू शुड टेक दैट एडवाइस राइट Yeah. I think the thought process which is evolving here is that one, that you know, we need to develop more channels. Then second, that regulation should not be harsh. And third, give the consumer as much as you can, and you know, carry as much as you can. Now it is the 10 minutes.
Rajin, Nilanjana is saying sorry? Enough is enough.
I'm saying let's do a Q&A.
Yeah, that's what I'm going to do. So another 10, time for questions. Yeah. Please ask some questions. Otherwise, they will ask questions. No questions. That means nobody understands. Please identify your name and...
I'm Shopnindu from Akashtori, Durgapur, West Bengal.
Okay.
My question is to Prashantji. You said the regulation is in the right way, but we all stakeholders are thinking that we are downgrading ourselves, or rather we are getting downgraded by virtue of this regulations. And as per Khareji's initial comments, it was not framed in that way. See, our set-top boxes which we are using is not, which is not able to cope up with the current system, current NTO or one or NTO two. If it is goes a la carte, then set-top boxes as well as cash, as well as SMS systems, everything we have to rethink. Now it is going, the cash SMS is a head-end opportunity which can be changed. But when it comes to the set-top boxes, it is going to be electronic garbage. Our government policy is done in such a way that in due course it is going to be, we are losing our valued currencies. As well as not only Indian investments, which is going down, and we have to reinvest again to cope up with the regulations. That is what I mean to say, and I want an answer for that.
No, I agree with you. So even now, whenever I speak to any MSO friends or anybody who is in the industry, when they are saying, "Hum Android box dal rahe hain, hum box change kar rahe hain." तो मैं हर किसी को बोलता हूँ भाई मैं तुमको व्हाट्सएप भेजता हूँ ये स्पेसिफिकेशंस चेक करो ये होना चाहिए खाली इंडिया में नहीं मैंने यूरोप में कम से कम 40 ऑपरेटर को उनके रॉन्ग इन्वेस्टमेंट से बचाया उनको मैं पूरे वर्ल्ड में 4K HDR के ऊपर भाषण देता हूँ हर कंट्री की सरकार मुझे अपने पैसे पर बुलाती है तो मैं जितना मैं सीखा हूँ इंटरनेशनली मैं यहाँ लोगों को बता रहा हूँ अभी आप अभी केबल डी केबलाइजेशन में जैसे डी मोनेटाइजेशन आया था आपका सेट टॉप बॉक्स 500 का नोट है इनका हेडेंट 2000 का नोट है वो गया आपको चेंज करना पड़ेगा रेगुलेशन इज गोइंग टू बी देयर देयर विल बी एनटीओ 3 एनटीओ 4 यू हैव टू बी डायनामिक इन नेचर यू हैव नो अदर चॉइस ये ऑप्शन नहीं है आपको बस कोई नहीं आप अभी कुछ भी बोलिए उसका कोई वैल्यू नहीं है
जस्ट वन थिंग आई एम नॉट कमिंग टू एनटीओ आई एम कमिंग टू डैश रेगुलेशंस वेयर द सेट टॉप बॉक्सेस कॉस्ट्स वाज लिमिटेड नाउ यू सी In 2011, the cost of a set-top box has to be provided within this amount of money, and in that money, providing 4K or Android boxes, what amount of money a person like Shurezda have to invest with 6 million homes for the consumers? See the thing, the volume. Which investor has to invest to get the market?
No, but
coming to that calculation,
if he has to invest $40 per consumer, कुछ नहीं है, 2500 रुपए डाल के साल का 3000 आ रहा है, 100% return एक साल में आ रहा है, और एक डब्बा 3 से 5 साल चलता है minimum. Problem क्या है? एक connection की value अगर आप देखें तो 15000 है. तो मैं हमेशा operator को मैं सुरेश जी को बोलता हूँ. कि आप एक चैनल बंद करके 100 कस्टमर निकाल देते हो कैरेज से ज्यादा पैसा वैल्यूएशन कम हो जाती है
15000 रुपए में अगर है तो आई थिंक बहुत लाइन लग जाएगी अभी बाहर में
खाली खाली वो एक बूथ लगा दो 15,000 रुपया पर पॉइंट केबल ऑपरेटर अभी भर लाइन लग
जाएगी है वैल्यू है अभी इनको बोलो बेचना है तो ये 20 से शुरू करेंगे
एनी मोर क्वेश्चंस नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन शिशिर एनी क्वेश्चन
माय नेम इज मोनी शंकर फ्रॉम एसएजी केबल मुझे करीबन पिछले 10-12 साल से ऐसा लग रहा है कि कहीं ना कहीं ऑपरेटर्स जो है लोकल ऑपरेटर्स जो है उनको एजुकेट करने की जरूरत है और उस विषय के अंदर ना तो ब्रॉडकास्टर्स ना ही एमएसओ ना ही बड़ी कंपनियां कोई कदम उठा रही हैं कोई भी टेक्निक आए या कोई भी नए नियम्स आते हैं उनके लिए एलसीओ को खुद कहीं ना कहीं भागदौड़ करनी पड़ती है और बाद में उसकी माल झेलनी पड़ती है तो इस विषय के अंदर ब्रॉडकास्टर्स या आप लोग क्या करते हैं
मैं आपसे कहता हूँ रस्तोगी जी इसमें इनिशिएटिव लें मैं अवेलेबल हूँ 24/7/365 आप बोलिए हिंदुस्तान के कौन से कोने में कहाँ आना है जितना मुझे आता है मैं सिखा के जाऊँगा और गारंटी देता हूँ गलत नहीं सिखाऊंगा अगर आप इनिशिएटिव लें तो पूरे इंडिया में 10-12 कैंप कीजिए 15 दिन में 20 दिन में कहानी खत्म सबको मालूम पड़ जाएगा क्या होने वाला है और बुलाइए 5-6 लोगों को जगह जगह जाके रादर देन कमिंग टू दिल्ली लेट्स गो टू 12 स्टेट्स टॉक टू एवरी द होल इकोसिस्टम एक्सप्लेन टू देम फ्यूचर क्या है 5 years फ्रॉम नाउ क्या होने वाला है उसके ऊपर सब लोग अपना प्रेजेंटेशन दें
नहीं कई साल से डॉक्टर साहब जैसे लगे हुए हैं इस मुहिम के अंदर इसी तरीके
से इसीलिए उनको ही दे रहा हूं
इसी तरीके से कुछ ऐसे अप्रिशिएट किए जाए कि भाई मतलब वीकली या मंथली ऐसा कुछ अपडेशन आना चाहिए कि एलसीओस तक पूरी नॉलेज पहुंचे पूरी जानकारी पहुंचे हर चीज के बारे में चाहे वो वेब सीरीज के थ्रू हो जरूर ठीक है ना कि भाई आप डायरेक्टली नहीं कर सकते अरेंज नहीं कर सकते तो उसके लिए कोई ना कोई ऐसा एक प्रॉपर चाहे आप चैनल्स के ऊपर कीजिए जब आप अपने रेट बढ़ाने के लिए या कुछ चेंजेस करने के लिए आप अपने नॉलेजेबल चैनल्स के ऊपर डाल सकते हैं कि सो एंड सो डेट से ये चीज़ चेंजेस होने वाली है इतना नंबर चैनल्स देखें तो उसके लिए एलसीओज को कहीं ना कहीं मेरे ख्याल से साथ ले लिया गया था थोड़ी देर पहले सर कह रहे थे कि एफएमसीजी इंडस्ट्री ले लीजिए या दूसरे इंडस्ट्रीज ले लीजिए उसमें रिटेलर्स से लेके ऊपर तक की पूरी चेन को साथ लेके चला जाता है लेकिन इस इंडस्ट्री के अंदर मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि कहीं ना कहीं एलसीओ को सिर्फ एक चारा समझ के यूज़ किया जाता है कि जितना निचोड़ सकते हो निचोड़ लो भाई इन्वेस्टमेंट तेरी सब कुछ तेरा हमें तो सिर्फ अपने प्रॉफिट चाहिए हर तरीके से इस विषय के अंदर आप लोग कैसे एजुकेट करेंगे एलसीओ को नहीं भाई तू चारा नहीं है तू ही वो है जो हमारे लिए सब कुछ लेके आता है ग्राउंड पे से बिकॉज जो मेन फोर्स है फ्रंट फोर्स चाहे आप लोन्स के अंदर चले जाइए फाइनेंस के अंदर चले जाइए कहीं भी जाइए जो फ्रंट सेल टीम होती है वो सबसे ज़्यादा महत्व रखती है क्योंकि वही सब कुछ लेके आती है आपके लिए कस्टमर्स लेके आती है यहाँ कंटेंट को कस्टमर तक पहुँचाने का जो सबसे बड़ा काम है अपनी पूरी की पूरी जो उसके वैल्यू है जो उसके पास जो भी जुड़ा हुआ है उसको टोटल रोड्स पे लटका के मैं लैक्स के अंदर इन्वेस्टमेंट होती है एलसीओ की और टोटल कोई किसी लोकर में नहीं है कोई किसी मतलब शटर के अंदर नहीं है सारा रोड के ऊपर पड़ा हुआ वो सब कुछ वही झेलता है बेचारा चाहे एनडीपीएल उसकी कटिंग करे कल को वन विभाग आके उसकी कटिंग कर दे कल को कोई और भी ऑफिसर्स आ जाते हैं पहले तो ऐसा होता था कि टैक्स डिपार्टमेंट के लोग आके डायरेक्ट उसको हैरेस करते थे आजकल वो चीज़ तो नहीं रही लेकिन आप एक बात सोचिए कि उसको मिलता क्या है एंड ऑफ द डे
आपका प्रश्न बिल्कुल सही है लेट मी गिव यू स्मॉल बैकग्राउंड ऑन दिस मैं जब हिंदुजा ग्रुप में था अभी तक का हम लोग ने एक एक्सपेरिमेंट किया था ये लास्ट जब NTO 1 आया था वी हैड मेड मोर देन 100 लोकेशंस का पूरा ट्रेनिंग सेशन फॉर फुल ऑपरेटर ग्रुप्स ऑफ एवरेजिंग 50 to 100 वी ट्रेंड मोर देन 6,000 to 7,000 ऑपरेटर्स आई विल जस्ट लेट मी कंप्लीट नाउ व्हाट वी रियलाइज इज जो आप बता रहे हैं कि दैट ट्रेनिंग चौधरी साहब आई शुड टेल यू दैट ट्रेनिंग जो एक बार एक राउंड में होता है वो सिर्फ इनिशिएटर है उसमें हम लोगों ने ये ऑब्जर्व किया एंड आई एम टेलिंग यू दैट फॉर द बेनिफिट ऑफ द एंटायर इंडस्ट्री एंड हूएवर इज विलिंग शुड कम अप टुगेदर एंड जॉइंट इट एंड जॉइंटली डू इट इन फैक्ट टुडे आई एम इन अ प्रोफेशन विच ऑल्सो गिव्स अ लॉट ऑफ ट्रेनिंग एंड एजुकेशन एंड दिस थिंग टू द वेरियस एरियाज बट आई कैन ओनली अश्योर यू दैट दिस इज वन एरिया which the government was aware, when they opened the National Skill Development Council, we along with some of my old friends had met up to the highest level of MIB and Skill Council, MDA, etc. But what they tried to do did not work properly. We are aware of that. So the only thing which I now agree with here also, with the forum here and the entire holistic team here, that it has to come again from the private industry. It will not work if the government tries to so-called train us. So I would recommend that this is one area which can be highlight of this seminar, sir, Dr. Astogi, sir, that this is what we are willing to do. I have done it in past in the IMCL, in the Hinduja group, in the last 2-3 years. It was a sizable success, but this, there is a huge gap, and we completely, not only on the NTO side itself, there is an issue of the entire dynamics of the business model, dynamics of the so-called taxation issues, dynamics of the collection methodology. So there is a holistic things for the operator groups who should be enlightened. Honestly, it was the job of each MSO. I don't mean, sir, you must be doing a lot of work. Each MSO is doing in their own way. I don't deny it, and they are doing their whatever best. But it is only the handful, big 4 or 5. What happens to the medial, which I again said, which falls under MSME? What happens to those people who are in a limited head and viewership of 2 lakh, 5 lakh, 10 lakh kind of a pub? I think nothing has been done for them, and we will work on this area, and we have taken this inputs very rightly, and we, I think the industry should work out a private forum to ensure this can be dedicated. But I'm sure the lot of larger MSO groups like Dr. Sethia's and other groups are doing, and I'm sure you would like to add up something.
सर मैं एक छोटी सी बात ऐड करना चाहूँगा कि जो सुभाषिश बोल रहे हैं या प्रशांत जी बोल रहे हैं वो डेफिनेटली होना चाहिए क्योंकि उनके पास जो नॉलेज है वो नॉलेज इंटरनेशनल नॉलेज है जो हमारे साथ शेयर हो सकता है लेकिन वो जो नॉलेज है वो नॉलेज कब आपके पास आएगा कितने दिन में आएगा उसकी आज की गारंटी नहीं है जो हम छोटी सी चीज़ कर सकते हैं आज एक टाइम था केबल ऑपरेटर कंज्यूमर के घर तक जाता था आज उसका स्टाफ ही जाता है केबल ऑपरेटर नहीं जाता है मैं ऐसा केबल ऑपरेटर बोल रहा हूँ खुद भी केबल ऑपरेटर हूँ वो नहीं जाता है तो हमारे स्टाफ की ट्रेनिंग बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है जो आप खुद कर सकते हो और वो खाली कंज्यूमर से बिहेवियर कैसा करे उतनी ज़रूरत है एक अच्छे कपड़े पहन के जाए चाहे वो अपनी कंपनी की एक टी शर्ट बन जाए
सर मैं खुद डील करता हूँ ऑपरेटर अपने सारे कस्टमर से
हाँ सर
मैं खुद डील करता हूँ अपने सारे कस्टमर से एवरी वीक
सर
पहली बात
आप एक्सक्लूसिव वैसे केबल ऑपरेटर होंगे मैं महीने में नहीं भी करके 1000-2000 केबल ऑपरेटर से मिलता हूँ जैसे सुभाषिश बोला ट्रेनिंग क्लासेस भी कराता हूँ और मैंने ऐसा पाया है कि एक टाइम में उसके कंज्यूमर से बहुत अच्छा कनेक्ट था वो नहीं रहा और उसी के वजह से हमारी कनेक्टिविटी हमारी अंडरस्टैंडिंग विद कंज्यूमर्स कम हो गई है हमारी कनेक्टिविटी विद अगर कंज्यूमर रहेगी तो हमको कोई ट्रेनिंग की ज़रूरत नहीं है हमारी भाषा हमारा कंज्यूमर समझता है और उस कंज्यूमर को क्या रिक्वायरमेंट है वो हमको उसके पास जाने से ही समझ में आ जाएगा
सर वो कनेक्टिविटी कंपनी और एलसीओ के बीच में भी तो रहनी चाहिए ना खाली कस्टमर और एलसीओ के बीच में मेरा क्वेश्चन कस्टमर और आपके बीच में नहीं है
मैं जो सोचा कि आप कंज्यूमर के बारे में बात कर रहे हो ऐसा नहीं एमएसओ एंड केबल ऑपरेटर कनेक्टिविटी आई थिंक वी ट्राई टू कीप अगर कहीं गैप है द केबल ऑपरेटर शुड सजेस्ट एमएसओ
मैं भी बिल्कुल इसी गैप के
शुड ऑलवेज बी उसमें कोई डाउट ही नहीं है उसमें कोई डिस्कशन है ही नहीं सर
थैंक यू सर
Today, what is happening is that this point which has come up now, there is this organization which Khare Sahab has given the initiative in India, SCTE. Their job itself is to give training, impart training to, you know, all levels of people, including not only in technical, but also in handling consumers and various other fields. There are few like Subhashish said, the responsibility is on the MSO, the main distributor, to interact with his operators and build that kind of a system, which is not happening. And some of them are doing, some are not doing. So then, you know, the initiative can be by, you know, from the industry side, which will come from organizations like Aavishkar Media. I think there is a need here for Aavishkar Media, SCTE, and we all know that the government of India is allocated huge amounts to, you know, upgradation of skill in and under skill development. So there is a lot happening in this, but somewhere as an industry we need to work along with this whole thing instead of missing out on that. And the final takeaway from the discussion is that we need to build more on our own strengths. It is also required that especially between the MSO and the cable operator, there has to be some more amount of mutual respect and mutual trust, which once developed, once established, they will get more respect from the next level, the broadcaster also, that to get more respect from other people, first respect each other. So that is absolutely essential. And of course, our pointer to the regulator is that regulation should not be harsh.
So we will close this session over here. Thank you, Subhashish, Setya Sab, Shirish, Prashant, for actively being in the session. Thank you all for taking time to be part of this discussion. I also take this opportunity. I'm missing Mohanji, who used to be here on the panel many a time along with us. So my respects to Mohanji and Surjit. Thank you all.
I second with you. We'll be really missing, we are really missing Mohanji today. But before we wind up, we need a big round of applause for Rastogi ji, Anurag and Aman, who do a great job of putting us all together on a particular day. Thank you so much, Rastogi ji. Thank you so much, Anurag, and thank you so much, Aman, and the team.
And you can only grow from here in a different level, Rastogi sahab, and the full team. I think this is an area which needs in this country in a very big way. And I'm sure with this kind of panel and this kind of teams, we can take this industry in a different height. All the best. Thanks a lot.
Thank you very much, gentlemen, for being a part of this session. May I request Dr. Rastogi to please felicitate our, the moderator and the panelists. A token memento for taking out the time, for being here, and for such an engaging session. A memento to Mr. Shaji Matthews, industry observer, and who was also the moderator of this session. A memento to Mr. Prashant Chothani, founder and CMD, Travel XP. A memento to Mr. Suresh Sethia, Director, ICNCL, Kolkata. To Mr. Shirish Pattanchetti, MD, Entertain Media, Fakht Marathi. And Mr. Shubhashish Majumdar, Digital Media Expert. Let's quickly have a group photograph also. Thank you very much, gentlemen.